We're still here at the Eco Hotel with the FMDQ OTC's Nigeria Debt Capital Market Workshop, and we are here with Ms. Twi Sani of she's the CEO of United Capital, and basically we're going to be continuing the discussion. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
I want to talk on the side of inclusion. We've spoken a lot about the debt capital market, and I mean, the first thing I would think about is that an individual like me can't just walk into the OTC and say, hey, can I buy two or three units of that bond mm-hmm. that you just issued?
Yeah.
I mean, first of all, why is it so, and how can individuals, you know, get to participate in the market?
Okay, individuals should ideally be able to participate in the market under the current regime through their brokers and financial advisors, investment banking groups like us,
yes.
like United Capital. And as I mentioned earlier, United Capital was able to bring to the market last year amongst several state government bonds. We brought to the market the premier FMDQ listed bond,
yes,
which
yes,
was the UBA
true.
Bond,
yeah,
which was
that.
Also dual listed at the NSE and the FMDQ, which was also the first of that type of instrument. So point I'm making is that we're very active in the debt capital market. We have a big stake in this market.
Yeah.
We just closed again another, you know, significant corporate bond issue, even in an environment where there's a dearth of corporate bond corporate instruments. Now, it is very much in our interest that these instruments should be available to the largest pool of investors possible. We think that there is room for a handshake between the banking industry, the retail banking industry, and the investment banking industry, because the retail banks still have the largest access to individual investors. We think that these individual investors are looking for investment outlets that will give them higher returns than they will get in your typical savings account. We think, therefore, that there should be room for us to pass through and sell a lot of instruments that are coming out of the capital market through banking accounts by way of maybe linked notes that will be alternative investments.
Okay.
And the banks also win. They retain their clients and the ability to advise their clients of better investment outlets. There is room for whatever, you know, commissions the regulators will allow. But definitely there must be a greater, you know, handshake.
On the regulator side, are we moving towards this direction? Is the regulator looking at also making it open to the wider
market? Yeah, what I will say is that the regulators are committed to the growth of collective investment schemes. Collective investment schemes, for example, a bond fund, a money market fund. These are instruments that we think can help to create that very critical handshake between the money market and the capital market. So, to the extent that we are engaging with the regulators to see what additional incentives can be put in place to drive the growth of collective investment instruments, because those are the kind of instruments typically that would then be pushed through the banking system.
You spoke about the fact that you listed the premier bond on the FMDQ OTC, which is fantastic, by the way. And we saw your numbers recently, and they were very good.
So, thank you.
I mean, could you just give us an insight into what United Capital is doing over the next, say, maybe 12 months or so?
Okay, over the next 12 months, we hope to bring to the market more debt capital market issues. So that's on the capital market side. And of course, also equity capital market offerings. We also continue to increase our asset management play. Of course, I'm sure you may be aware that we were recently appointed as fund managers to the ALCB fund in addition to or jointly with Lion's Head in the United Kingdom. We're making pitches to have more of such funds coming under our umbrella. So in terms of local currency bonds funded from offshore and domestically, those are some of the initiatives we're working on. On the trustee side, we continue to be the leading trust business in this market. And on the securities side, we're hoping and we're positioning ourselves that as the macroeconomic indices improve and there is renewed activity in the stock market, you know, then we can also continue to provide the excellent services that we provide to investors. We are also positioned as a regional provider. So we have partnerships with other agencies in the rest of Africa and are able to service our clients' needs through them. I don't know whether you also know that we completed the first cross-border trade between Nigeria and Ghana under the West African Capital Market Integration Initiative, which we're very committed to. So those are some of the things we're doing and we hope to deepen.
We'll continue to follow that story. Thank you very much for being with us. Yes, that's Mrs. Toyi Sani, MD, United Capital. She's been with us talking about the capital market as a whole, and she's giving us a bit of an insight into what they'll be doing over the next 12 months. We look forward to that. Still stay with us. We're here at the Okoso at FMDQ Nigeria Debt Capital Market Workshop. Don't go anywhere.